Hello, good morning everyone. Today we are going to review how to detect the trend of any indicator and how to use it as a filter or as an entry or exit signal. On the left we have Ninja 7, on the right Ninja Trader 8. And in both examples we are going to use Marker Plus tools to detect the trend. First, we need to identify two different types of indicators. This one is a super trend. This other is a parabolic SAR. And the difference between them is that one has two different lines if we click on the middle button, or we can add the show data box so we can see all the lines painted on the chart. We can see that this indicator has two plots, one for the uptrends, another for the downtrends, while the other, the parabolic SAR, has only one. The difference is that on this indicator, when the trend is to the upside, one line has value and the other line has no value. So we need to use a different method on each type of indicator. On the parabolic SAR, for example, the same plot is used for uptrends or downtrends. Most of the indicators are divided into one of these categories, so we need to use one or the other method that we are going to explain today. For the parabolic SAR, where we only have one line, it was seen on the previous video. We only need to copy the line and also the price. So we use the copy. We select the only line that has this indicator. For this example, it is a parabolic SAR. And assign a name, and we get at the bottom the copied version of the line. We can see that both matches, the original and the copy. And then to identify if the price is above or below, we need to copy the price. I don't want to show the line, don't want to use a new panel for the close. So now we have the close copied into a variable named close. Now we calculate the distance between the close and the line. We use the crossover between these two copied lines. One is the parabolic SAR. We can assign a different name like SAR. And close. Then we calculate the crossover between SAR and close. The result, the difference between them is my delta. And we don't need painted signals. We can see what happens leaving them enabled. We can see that we have a crossover to the upside, to the downside. We get signals and also a histogram at the bottom. For this example, we can see that they are inverted because we have the crossover of the SAR over the price instead of the opposite. All this section is positive while the trend is to the downside. So to correct this problem, we just invert the order of the variables. Instead of SAR versus close, we type close versus SAR. And that's all. Now we have this short signal, long signal. When the trend is to the downside, the histogram is negative. So now we can use the histogram at the bottom as a filter for our markers conditions. So on any indicator that has only one line, we can use this method. But when we have an indicator like supertrend or any other that uses more than one line, the problem is that we have two different lines to copy. And if we copy the first line, let's say supertrend number one, and here we type any supertrend, we select one of the lines, for example the uptrend. We can see that what we get at the bottom with the result, there is a bug present on NinjaTrader 7. If we overlap both lines, the original and the copy, we can see that while the line has a value, while the supertrend has a value, the copied line is follows it. But when it doesn't have a value, when we get an NA non-available, the copy is equal to the close of the price. This is not a markers problem, just an NinjaTrader 7 issue that happens when we copy an input parameter where an indicator don't have a result. For example, if we use the simple moving average with a period of one and on input series we select the supertrend with any line, let's say we take the average of the supertrend with one bar. This is just the supertrend because this is an average of one bar. We can see that the bug is still present. So the problem is how NinjaTrader 7 understands when the input series don't contains a value. This is not happening on NinjaTrader 8. We can see here we have the both examples with the SAR and supertrend. If we copy one of the lines of the supertrend, we select the same indicator with one of the lines, for example the uptrend, we can see that this is not happening. When the supertrend has a value, the copied version has the same value. But when it doesn't have a value, the copied version is the same. It doesn't have a value too. On Ninja 8, to detect the trend of this type of indicator, it is very easy. We only need to detect if the line is if the line has a value. So we copy the line the uptrend, and also we copy the downtrend. Here we copy the downtrend and I will use a different color, red, and these dotted lines are the copied version of the real supertrend, and we can see that both are okay. they only have value where the original version exists. And now if we want to filter, if you want to use this as a filter on the filter conditions of markers, we only need to configure one filter, like for example the supertrend must has a value bigger than zero. With just applying a filter means that the variable must exist, so just testing being bigger than zero is enough. The supertrend is always bigger than zero, so if it exists, then it will throw a true result. We can check now if this works. And we can see that we have longs enabled and shorts disabled. Just to remind what we are doing, I am just copying the uptrend on one variable and copying the downtrend on another variable. For the long conditions, my only condition is that it has to be bigger than zero for both. So with this method, we can filter any indicator that paints the trend using two lines instead of only one. Now we are going to change the trend. Shorts are still enabled until the red supertrend is broken. Now it is on long mode and the short mode are disabled. We can also disable the filter and take all the signals, or filter our signals with the supertrend. So this is the method to create a filter according to the trend defined by an indicator that paints two lines. When the indicator paints only one line, we can use the same method that we described for the SAR. We only copy the line, copy the price, the close, and calculate the distance between the price and the close. When that distance is positive, the trend is to the upside. When that distance is negative, the trend is to the downside. On NinjaTrader 7, because we have this bug, we need to do something special. So one possible solution is looking at the low of the bar. We can copy the low and check that low against the line. So when the low of the bar is over the supertrend or the line, the trend is to the upside. When the low of the bar is equal or lower than the line, the trend is to the downside. Here the lows are always over the line. And here the lows of the bar are always below or equal to the line. So it is complicated but possible. We use the copy indicator. I will remove the simple moving average. And let's start by copying the line. I will assign the name supertrend 1, sub 1. And we copy one of the lines. For example, the uptrend. Here we can see what happens when the line has no value. And now we need to copy the low of the bar. We use the copy, assign a name, for example, low, and on input series, we select low. I don't want to show the low, neither I want to use a panel. So now we can calculate the distance between the low of the bar and the line. For that we use the crossover indicator against low and supertrend number one, sup one. The difference between them, or the distance, is my delta. At the bottom, on the histogram, we can see green bars when the trend is to the upside, and red or zero when the trend is to the downside. I will remove the arrows because we don't need those arrows. I will also remove the parabolic SAR. And now we can do the filter. Let's say that we have markers and we need to assign only longs when the histogram is positive, only shorts when the histogram is negative or zero. So we go to the filters inside markers. And for the longs, the name of the variable is the one that we defined on the crossover, my delta. For longs, we want a my delta bigger than zero and not including zero. So it must be at least one tick. One tick on crude oil is 0.01. And to enable shorts, we need a my delta lower or equal to zero, because zeros are also included. Now let's check if this works. Currently we have shorts enabled, and here we are on long enabled, short disabled, because the trend is to the upside. This is for standard indicators that don't have a way to show the trend, like for example the custom supertrend indicator. On our indicator or version of the supertrend, the indicator store supertrend, we have a special parameter to detect the trend. With the op mode we can set it to 1. With 0 we have a standard supertrend, and we set the op mode to 1, then we get an additional plot. This is not for visual purposes, only to detect the trend. We get this new plot entry with a possible value of minus 1 or plus 1 depending on the trend. This is only useful for use as a filter. So we can copy, for example, let's set this to 0 again. And now we copy the same indicator, and here we use our custom supertrend indicator. but assigning the op mode to 1 and copying the entry line. So now we get this plot with possible values of plus 1 when the trend is to the upside or minus 1 when the trend is to the downside. Very easy to use as a filter. If we want to create a filter with this, we only need to use the variable, and on markers we place the same variable on the longs and on the shorts, and it is already configured because we need the variable bigger than 0 for longs or small below 0 for shorts. The same on NinjaTrader 8, we can also use the custom indicator with the op mode set to 1. So we get the entry line with the value of the trend. This is only useful when we copy this value, or we can also use it on Market Analyzer. Hope this has been useful for you, and if you have any question, please post below this video. Thank you everyone, bye bye.